Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey. What we'll show you guys, how to remove and replace radiator fan. Stay with us, doesn't matter which engine you have, the procedure should be the same. Now, we'll have guys more than 200 videos on this car, so please subscribe to the channel. Quite a few videos will be made. Our goal is guys to save you as much money as we can by teaching you how to fix your car for free. All the tools and parts will be listed in the description of the video below. We're constantly getting new cars, we'll be putting an engine on another Dodge, so many things at the shop. Now let me show you, here is your radiator fan, okay, right here. So that's what we'll be removing and replacing. Always disconnect the car battery when you replace the fan, because if you stick your fingers and it turns on, it's going to cut your fingers off, so be careful. Now, let's go ahead and start on the process. So, we'll remove the airbox out first. Okay, that will be the first procedure. What I'll do, okay, right here. Okay, we're going to disconnect, okay, this hose. This one will be the first step. Okay, you can see just like that. Now, with 8mm guys, we're going to remove a few bolts. Okay, that clamp, get that one loose. Okay, we're going to pull the lid up in a second. Okay, and remove the filter. Okay, like that. You can see this is the first step. Next guys, okay, definitely need to clean here a little bit. Next, we're going to get a bag and cover our intake boot, so that way we don't drop anything inside, we don't get dust. Okay, just like that. You can see now right here, we need to remove that bolt on top. Okay, right here. This is one of them. Okay, perfect. Next, right here, okay, down there, there is one more bolt. And this one is with 8, I think. Looks like it's an 8mm socket that we'll need to remove. You can see it's holding there. So, let's get the extension quick so we can reach it. Okay, I'm trying to focus here. You can see that's where the bolt is located. Okay, it looks like it's loose now. Okay, nothing else holding. We need to remove that clip now here. Okay, with the clip removal too. Okay, you can see this thing is actually pretty tight. Okay, now let's see if it's going to come out. Okay, and lift the box out of the way, just like that. So now we need to disconnect the wires. Perfect. Now we need to disconnect all the cables. One. Okay, now we have one more there. So let me see this one. Okay, you use that thing, lift it up and pull it out. Okay, this is kind of like a Volkswagen plug. Okay, perfect. Now 8mm socket, two bolt screws actually, and one right here. Perfect. And we just dropped our socket there. No? Disconnect the hoses. Okay, like that. We need to pull up. Okay, guys, and now. So we can flip this thing on the side now. Okay, guys, and this is your radiator fan. Okay, right here now. For the fan, you can see we have one bolt here, one bolt over there. Okay, and we'll see what else we have holding. So let's check it out. This looks like it's a 10 millimeter socket. So let's go ahead and remove that one quick now. We'll need to disconnect all the wires as well. Okay, one bolt. Now this one on top, guys, we need to use the ratchet. Okay, it's this one right here. Perfect. Now we can grab the fan. Okay, let's see if we have anything else holding here or not. Okay, there is one more on the bottom bolt. And one more on this side. So four bolts, guys. So we'll need to grab a smaller thing. Okay, this is the bolt. Okay, right here we need to get a shallow socket to remove it. Or a wrench. Okay, so shorter socket now, guys. Okay, let me see. Now it goes by hand. This is it, this is the bolt. Okay, right here. Now, we have one more towards the bottom there. Okay, let me come on this side. Okay, we dropped our two now. So let me see where we can reach that thing from. It's very inconvenient. And on the airbox, we just noticed that we have one more bolt here if you need to remove it. Ours came loose somehow, we didn't even notice it. Now, we need to pull it up. Okay, it's going to come only one way somehow, and then we need to disconnect our wires as well. So let's see. Okay, where it's hitting. Okay, you can see it's hitting down there a little bit, so we need to find a way. Okay, to turn it maybe. So we can get it out. Okay, yep, right here. It came out on this side. So we need to get that side up. Okay, now let's see. Okay, if we can come up a little bit more. Okay, those pipes right here, I'll get them in a little bit. No. It's still like it's holding, so we need to turn it a little bit somehow. Okay, let's see if we can move the whole thing. That I thought it would come out super easy, and it didn't. So we just turn it a little bit, pulled it out. Okay, we need to disconnect the wires now, guys. Okay, so right here there is a thing that we press in. Okay, and pull it out. So let's see how we're going. Okay, to disconnect it now. Okay, that's where the clip is. Located inside, and this thing is extremely hard to remove. So what we can do, okay, right here there is one clip. Okay, if we release that clip, we can actually pull it up. Okay, you can see that metal clip, okay, right here, came out. Now we can pull the fan up. And we can disconnect that one by pressing it in with a screwdriver. Okay, careful not to drop our things. And okay, here we need to push in and pull out. And this is, guys, your radiator fan out of the way. That's how you guys remove it. Replacement is in the same order. Check out the description of the video to see where we get our parts from. And see you guys next time.